James Gaffigan comes to conduct. Natasha Paremski plays Rachmaninov second. She subbed, I think, last minute Tchaikovsky.
She's amazing.
Yeah?
Yeah, she's
playing
something.
Her.
Oh, over the top. Woo! That's a real pianist.
Little pistol, huh?
Whoa, my God. And he's been very successful. He's been a very good conductor. I think he's in San Francisco, if I'm
He is. He's assistant in San Francisco.
Yeah. They liked him very much, the orchestra. I didn't actually see him conduct, but so we go along with that sometimes, you know, when they recommend somebody.
Why do you like to bring these people in? I mean, we don't know them. Isn't it a bit of a chance?
In the Gaffigan's case, they liked him very much. So when an orchestra says, we like somebody, go for it. Sure, bring him back immediately. Yeah. You know, of course. We have that wonderful program in the summer, so we can kind of look at them a little bit and then see what works. It's a long journey, making a career anyway, but particularly with a conductor. Oh, my goodness.
Well, it's important to support these, too.
Absolutely. Of course.
Not just same old all the time.
No. And it's good for the orchestra to see a young person that's maybe the next whatever. And they can be very good with that. They can help them. It's a good orchestra to do that with. You know, not every orchestra.
Why? Because they're generous?
They're flexible. Uh-huh. Very flexible. And they will play a good performance. The orchestra does an enormous amount of work. It's the kind of orchestra that that's very unusual in its sense. The instrument itself can play for the ballet, for the opera. We play a lot of modern music, of course, music of our times, and naturally the meat and potatoes now as well. So it's a all-rounded. It takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of preparation.
And we just see the result, right?
But they're very flexible. They're very flexible.